بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ورتل القرآن ترتيلا
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Welcome to another clip of Makharij Al-Huruf with Baba Salam. Today we are still in the letters of the throat, and in the previous two or three, we have covered the letters of the upper point of the throat with reference to our lips. And we also covered the letters, two letters that come from the middle of the throat. And now we have the letters that come from the lower point of our throat, and they are Hamza and Ha. Take a look at this point. So we already covered that Ayn and Ghain, or rather Ghain and Kha, come from somewhere here, all right? And we have Ayn and Ha coming from here, and now we have Hamza and Ha coming from here. If you look at this, Hamza and Ha that come from this point, the Hamza, how do we get it correct? If you just say Hamza, you will not feel it. But if you apply silence to the Hamza and you bring any active letter in front of it, then you'll be able to get the Hamza correct. So you say ta, a, ma, na, and whatnot, you will be able to get the Hamza. And if you do that, the vocal cord here must close. Ta, ta, ma, na, and whatnot. Then you can get it. If it is open, then you are going to get ha, ha. And ha is loosed in comparison to ha, which we mentioned that you need to compress the point, the middle or part of the throat here, in order to get the ha. All right. So let's take a look at some examples. We have the hamza fatatuna afwaja, fatatuna afwaja. We have two hamza here. One is silent fata, and the second is active. Fatatuna afwaja. And don't forget to, or don't undermine the other examples which we have covered in the past, or which we will come across in the future. So whatever we have not covered yet, we will still pronounce it to the best possible, so that when we come to it, we are already familiar with it. Fatatuna afwaja, fatatuna afwaja. And we have over here alhaakumut takathur. We have only hamza, one hamza here. الهاكم التكاثر الهاكم التكاثر alright and we have والله على كل شيء شهيد. One of the mistakes some of us do when they apply hamza is they overdo it. والله على كل شيء شهيد شيء شهيد. Relax. والله على كل شيء شهيد. And we have Utul kitab, utul kitab. Wama tafarraqa alladhina utul kitab, utul kitab. And when we come to the ha, we have kal'ihni al-manfush, kal'ihni, kal'ihni, kal'ihni. Do not push breath out of it, otherwise you are breathing in that case. Kal'ihni. No, kal'ihni. Remember, it comes from your throat, not from your chest. All right? Kal'ihni al-manfush. Of course, it will come with that breath, some of it, but it is not a breathing action to say. Kal'ihni al-manfush. And we have wujuhun yawma'idhin na'imah. So when you stop here, you are applying the same ha here, a silent one. Wujuhun yawma'idhin na'imah. Although this is ta, but we have to apply the rule of ha, which I believe you know. Yatlu suhufan mutahharah. Rasulun min Allah. Yatlu suhufan mutahharah. So this ha is different from this ha. All right? Let your loved one know this and remember this. Student, remember this. And anyone you are sharing with, as well as myself, remember this. يَتْلُو صُحُفًا مُطَهَّرَهُ مُطَهَّرَهُ. This ha over here is flat, and the thought is heavy, so do not mistake one with another or let them mingle with the characteristics of one another. And we have وَإِنَّهُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ لَشَهِيدٌ وَإِنَّهُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ لَشَهِيدٌ who push a little forward. ذَلِكَ لَشَهِيدٌ All right? And this ends the clip of this third part or this point, third point of the letters of the throat. Until the next. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
ورتل القرآن ترتيلا